Good morning, students. Today we are going to do the second topic of the chapter My Body, that is the skeletal system. So the learning outcomes of this chapter will be that you'll be able to know the importance of skeletal system. Ki skeleton hamari body mein kyun zaruri hai, you'll be able to know. Then gain knowledge of the composition. What things make the bones, and then recognize the features of skull, backbone, rib cage, and limbs. Then also explain the function of each in the body. All these four things, why they are needed in the body and what is the function of each of them. So let's get started. Now consider a house under construction. This is the house under construction, and you must have seen such type of iron bars being laid on the walls or over the window, over the doors. Have you ever wondered why such things are there? Well, they are to give the strength and stability to the walls, to the house. Such type of structures which give the strength and stability to the house and help the wall to stay erect. Okay, these are the skeletons of the house. Similarly, in our body, this is the skeletal system. This skeleton, this is the front view, side view, and the back side. This three poses, these form the skeletal system or the skeleton of our body. Now there are three main functions, yeah, or you can say importance of this skeletal system. Number one, it gives framework to the body. एक आपकी body में framework देता है कि इसके अंदर बाकी की bones fit होंगी. Then it gives shape and support to the body. Shape means कि ultimately all the human beings have the same shape because they have got same type of skeleton. अब एनिमल्स का स्केलेटन इज डिफरेंट देन द स्केलेटन ऑफ ह्यूमन बीइंग्स, बट रिमेंबर दैट व्हाटएवर शेप इज ऑफ योर बॉडी देन द स्केलेटन हेल्प्स टू गिव द शेप, ठीक है, एंड इट हेल्प्स टू सपोर्ट द बॉडी एंड ऑल्सो प्रोटेक्ट द इनर डेलिकेट ऑर्गन्स. आपके स्केलेटन के अंदर यू रिमेंबर हार्ट है, लंग्स है, ठीक है, अदर मस्कुलर आइटम है, आपका ब्रेन है, बैकबोन है, एक्सेट्रा. जितनी भी चीजें आपके स्केलेटन के अंदर फिट है, इट प्रोवाइड्स लाइक अ केज, राइट, एंड देन इट प्रोटेक्ट्स द इनर डेलिकेट ऑर्गन्स लाइक हार्ट, लंग्स, एक्सेट्रा, ब्रेन ऑल्सो. व्हाट विल हैपन इफ वी डू नॉट हैव स्केलेटन बोन्स? See, if we have a skeleton, we are going to stand erect like this. Our body has a proper shape. Otherwise, we will just be a big mass of skin. Right? So, this way, the skeleton is important for us. Let's know the features of the skeletal system. The skeleton of the adult human being is made up of 206 bones of different shapes and sizes. Different type की bones है, कोई long है, कोई short है, कोई किसी shape में, कोई किसी shape में. So there are different bones, but remember this number 206. 206 are the bones of the adult human being, while as a child has about 300 bones. Now how come a child has got 300? जो कि इतना छोटा baby है, उसकी 300 है, हमारी जो कि adult है, उसकी 206 है. Remember, when the child is born, the bones of his skull, sir ki jo uski bones hain, they are not joined together. They are not fused together. So, they are all individual bones. Alag-alag bones hoti hai. So, a child has got 300 small bones, while as a human being, when the bones are fused together, they are 206 in number. Let's know the features of the skeletal system. Now the bones are hard and strong structures. Otherwise though these bones are hard and strong, but remember if sometimes there is an accident, you fall off on your arm, your bones are the first ones which will break off. So, and also they are made of calcium, phosphorus and some other minerals. So this is point number two, that they are made up of calcium, phosphorus and other minerals. Bones are living entities, right? Living entities means that they can grow gradually from the baby to the adult. As you are growing, then your bones are also growing. And they have got nerves inside them. Look here. These zigzag things, these red lines, these are the blood vessels, these red lines are the nerves which are inside the bones. And they help us to know the pain. When a bone breaks, right, see, otherwise it is hard and rigid, but when there is a pressure applied on it, or you fall sometime, or there is an accident, then these bones can break under pressure. And then when the bone breaks, then we feel the pain inside the body. Also, these bones have channels. These are the channels that contain blood vessels. Look here, these blood vessels, red and thin lines, these are the blood vessels that run along the bone. Now, we are continuing this. The long bones like the thigh bone or the femur and the arm bone are hollow from inside. These are the long bones. Mention, look here, that these blue thigh bones and red hair in this side, these are the long bones. Okay, red side here and blue side here, these are the long bones and they are comparatively hollow from inside, but hollow, not like the birds, right? But they have got the spongy bone and the bone marrow inside them. So, if it is hollow, then something is to be there. Okay? Then it has got, it is filled with the cells, spongy bone and soft material called bone marrow. See here, this is the cutout of the bone, right? And inside the bone, just next to the outer side, inside there is a spongy bone. And inside the spongy bone, it has got this bone marrow. This bone marrow helps in the production of, manufacturing of blood cells. Hamara jitna bhi blood cells bante hain, blood banta hai, isi bone marrow se banta hai. Yahan par banta hai hamara blood, right? Bones ke andar, ye jo hamari arms ki bones hain, legs ki bones hain, iske andar hamara bone marrow hai, aur bone marrow mein hamare blood ke cells bante hain. And that is why bone marrow is called the factory for making blood cells. Okay, I'll repeat one more time. In the long bones, this red section, okay, in the long bones, we have got bone marrow, and this bone marrow makes the blood for our body, and that is why it is called the factory for making blood cells. Now, there are four parts of the skeletal system. First is skull, second is backbone, third is rib cage, and fourth is limbs. Limbs means your arms and legs. Look at the pictures. This is skull. This is backbone, which is at the back of your body. This is the rib cage, okay? And this is the arm and legs. These two make the limbs. Next, we'll do these things turn by turn. First of all, we'll do skull, okay? Now, the skull is made up of 8 flat bones. Look in this picture. You can see lines here, hai na? Aapko lag raha hai ki kuch kuch partition hai. But these are the bones which are present in your skull. They are fused together. There are 8 flat bones and they are fused together to make your skull look like this. Okay? And skull protects the delicate organ, most delicate organ, that is your brain. Aapke dimag ko yahi skull, it is a very hard object called a skull, and your brain is protected inside this skull. Look in this picture. In the skull, here is your brain. Your thinking power, your every body action is managed by your brain. So, this brain is inside the skull. In the skull, it has got two jaws. One is the upper jaw and the lower jaw. The upper jaw is attached to the skull itself and only your lower jaw is movable. Try it on your own. Try saying ah or try saying anything. When you eat, only the lower jaw, lower teeth section, only that section is movable, while as the upper jaw is immovable. And just because this lower jaw, this red section here, look at the red section. This red section is the lower jaw. Only this is movable and it helps you to eat, speak, talk and laugh. Okay, so we are done with skull. Now you'll be able to know backbone. See, this is at the backside of your body, you have your backbone. And backbone is connected to the skull. Hamari backside pe, it is connected to the skull. And there are 33 small bones called vertebrae. Okay, 33 small bones. This is not one in section. Ek nahi hai. It is not one. There are 33 small bones which are fused together and they make 33 vertebrae. And together, in sabko ikatthe plus kar le, to then they make one vertebral column. Okay. And remember this spinal cord, which is the main, this, look at this orange line here. This spinal cord passes through this backbone or the vertebral column. This spinal cord is very important for your body. It is the main part when your body or your brain is sending all the signals to the body. The spinal cord helps the signals to reach throughout the body. So, the spinal cord passes through the vertebral column. Also, the small vertebrae provide flexibility and movement to the backbone. Just because they are 33 in number and they are able to move, you can move your backbone downwards, backwards, sideways, both sides, left side, right side, you can move your backbone just because it is made up of small vertebrae. So it provides flexibility and movement to the backbone. Now we'll do third part, that is rib cage. Okay, so rib cage, so you can feel on your own. When you touch your chest, you can feel the rib cage. Right? There are approximately 12 pairs of rib. Pair means that on both the sides, this is your breast bone, which is in the middle. You can touch yourself and feel it. This is one pair. One this side, one this side. Just keep on looking at the arrow. This is one pair, two pair, three pair, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, and 10. And there are two at the back which are not attached. Okay, so there are 12 pairs of ribs. 10 in the front, two at the back, but those two which are not attached, okay, they are the floating ribs. Okay, I'll repeat again. So, there are 10 pairs like this, which are attached to the breast bone, which is in the front into the breast bone and in the back to the backbone, right? And there are two pairs which are not attached. These two red ones are not attached. And they are only attached to the backside, not to the breast bone. And these ribs are called as the floating ribs. बेटा जो नहीं attach हुई, इनको बोलते हैं floating ribs. ये सिर्फ तैर रही है body के अंदर. Just पीछे एक backbone से attached है, इसलिए बस वो लटक रही है backbone के साथ, लेकिन आगे breastbone के साथ attached नहीं है. Now what is the function of rib cage? Rib cage protects the delicate organs like your heart and your lung. ठीक है यहाँ पिंक वाले देखो दीज आर योर लंग्स एंड द दिस इनसाइड द लंग्स हेयर हेयर इज योर हार्ट ओके सो द मेन फंक्शन ऑफ द रिब केज इज टू प्रोटेक्ट योर हार्ट एंड लंग्स नाउ विल डू द फोर्थ सेक्शन दैट इज लिम्ब्स नाउ लिम्ब्स एज आई टोल्ड यू लिम्ब्स कंसिस्ट ऑफ फोर लिम्स एंड हिंड लिम्स, आर्म्स एंड लेग्स. ठीक है, फोर लिम्स आर आर्म्स एंड हिंड लिम्स आर लेग्स. द फोर लिम्स और द आर्म्स आर जॉइंट टू द स्पाइन बाय द शोल्डर गर्डल. ओके, लुक हियर, द फोर लिम्स और द आर्म्स, दिस साइड ऑन योर शोल्डर देर इज अ शोल्डर गर्डल. ओके, एंड कॉलर बोन, ये जो ऊपर वाली है ये बोन, ये ऊपर रेड जो दिख रही है, दिस इज योर कॉलर बोन. एग्जैक्टली आपकी जो शर्ट का कॉलर है उसके नीचे आपकी कॉलर बोन है, दिस कॉलर बोन. एंड जो पीछे आपके बैक साइड पे है शोल्डर गर्डल, इन दोनों के साथ ज्वाइन होती है हमारी फोर आर्म या आर्म. और जो हिंड लेग्स है या लेग्स है, दे आर फिटेड इन टू द हिप गर्डल. यहाँ पे दे आर, यू कैन टच योर लेग्स एट दिस जॉइंट एंड यू कैन फील दैट योर लेग्स आर अटैच्ड हेयर टू द हिप गर्डल. एंड रिमेम्बर द लेग्स बियर द वेट ऑफ द बॉडी. योर लेग्स जो है, आपकी सारी बॉडी का वेट आपकी लेग्स पे रहता है. द फोर लिम्स और द आर्म्स, जो मैं आपको पहले भी बता रही थी, द फोर लिम्स और द आर्म्स आर जॉइंट टू द स्पाइन बाय द शोल्डर गर्डल एंड कॉलर बोन. ये देखो, सो दिस इज योर शोल्डर गर्डल, ये बैक साइड से है, और ये कॉलर बोन है जो कि फ्रंट साइड से है. ठीक है, और इसके साथ ये हमारा जो आर्म है वो अटैच्ड होती है. ठीक है, सो दिस इज योर शोल्डर गर्डल रेड सेक्शन में देखो, और दिस इज योर कॉलर बोन. इन दोनों के साथ जो आर्म्स है, आपकी दोनों आर्म्स है वो अटैच्ड है. एंड नाउ द फोर लिम्स और द आर्म्स आर जॉइंट टू द स्पाइन बाय द शोल्डर गर्डल एंड कॉलर बोन. द अपर आर्म हैज गॉट वन बोन, जो ऊपर वाला सेक्शन है शोल्डर से लेके आपकी एल्बो तक का, इसमें देयर इज ओनली वन बोन. एल्बो से लेकर रिस्ट तक इट हैज गॉट टू बोन्स. ओके, आई रिपीट, द अपर आर्म हैज वन बोन एंड द लोअर आर्म हैज गॉट टू बोन्स एंड इन द हैंड देयर आर मेनी स्मॉल बोन्स इन योर पाम एंड फिंगर्स. ठीक है, आप अपनी फिंगर्स खोल के देख लो. ठीक है, एंड यू विल सी कि आपकी फाइव फिंगर्स जो है, फाइव फिंगर्स में हर बिट के नीचे एक बोन है. ठीक है, सो देयर आर, यू हैव गॉट मल्टीपल बोन्स इन योर पाम एंड फिंगर्स. सिमिलरली इन योर लेग्स, योर लेग्स आर फिटेड इन टू द हिप गर्डल, यही वाला जो मैं आपको बता रही थी, दिस थिंग, दिस इज द हिप गर्डल एंड द लेग्स बियर द वेट ऑफ द बॉडी. इन योर अपर लेग हियर, इन योर अपर लेग इट हैज गॉट वन बोन, इन द लोअर लेग अगेन वी हैव टू बोन्स. नाउ देयर आर मेनी स्मॉल बोन्स इन द एंकल, वॉच द एरो हियर, दिस इज द एंकल. Small bones in the ankle and the toe region. आपके जो पैर है उसमें भी देर आर वेरी मेनी स्मॉल बोन्स. द अपर पार्ट ऑफ दिस बोन, दिस अपर पार्ट, ये जो आपका हिप गर्डल है, दिस इज योर हिप गर्डल, और उसमें ये सारी आपकी लेग अटैच्ड है. ठीक है, जो अपर पार्ट है दिस इज कॉल्ड एज द थाई बोन और फीमर. It is the longest bone in your body. And again, this is the lower leg. And also the femur is connected to the lower two bones of the leg at the knee. यहाँ पे जो knee है, this is your knee and it is connected here. Both the legs, these two bones and this femur is connected here at the knee. In the forelimbs, remember this is the labeling that in your forearm or in your arm, this is the shoulder joint, this is upper arm, which is one, the point where these bones and this bones join, this is the elbow, this is the lower arm, which are two in number, and then these are your fingers. Similarly, in the lower section in your legs, this is the hip girdle. This is the femur bone or the thigh bone, which is the longest bone. This is your knee. This is your lower leg, which are two in number, and these are ankle and toes. Remember, this is a very interesting fact that this, I told you the longest bone is femur, while as the shortest bone or the smallest bone is the stapes or stirrup, and it is present in our ear and it measures about 1/4 of the centimeter. अपना स्केल लेके सेंटीमीटर खोलो, 1 सेंटीमीटर का भी 4th पार्ट, दिस इज द स्टिरप बोन एंड दिस इज द क्लोजअप ऑफ द स्टिरप बोन. दिस इज द क्लोजअप ऑफ स्टिरप बोन. ऑल्सो देर इज वन इंटरेस्टिंग फैक्ट दैट ह्यूमन बींग्स, ह्यूमन स्केलेटन एंड द स्केलेटन ऑफ जिराफ, दे हैव गॉट 7 bones इन देयर नेक. We have got 7 bones and giraffe has also got 7 bones. But just see the comparison. Giraffe has got such long neck while as we have got a very small neck. So with this, we end today's video lesson. And now, next we'll be doing the topic joints, right? You can go through this video again and then you will revise the major section of our chapter, that is the skeletal system. Goodbye till then. Take care.